So, Auburn, were you Auburn following growing up or
fan? I was not. But like I said, the Alabama week, you know, half the state is Auburn, and then half of like my family is was Auburn, you know, being from Alabama, like cousins and all that. So they definitely know a lot of Auburn fans.
Were you on the Alabama half?
No, you know, my dad and we grew up in Alpharetta, Georgia, so we were a little bit distant from that, but then we moved to Birmingham when I was 14 and got right back into it. So but no, that's so that I know a lot of people that, you know, pull for Auburn.
So what's sort of your perception of the Georgia Auburn rivalry?
I know it's one of the oldest, if not the oldest. I know, you know, we played, and it's 55-8, and I mean, they've been playing football a long time around here and around there, and so this rivalry goes back real far. Obviously, it's dead even, so it's been an evenly matched rivalry. So, you know, we're just looking, you know, hopefully to gain an edge on Saturday.
The prayer at Jordan-Hare last time, Georgia was there. You didn't have to be a part of that team to probably notice or recognize that. What was your memories from that? Where were you?
I was on an airplane home from Marshall. I remember that very, very specifically. We were about to take off when Georgia just scored to take the lead. And when you take off, you can't watch TV. But then once we got into the air, the game's over, and Auburn had won, and then, you know, we were all freaking out. You know, we didn't know what happened, and then when we saw the highlights, we didn't get to see it live, so it's kind of weird how that happened, but I do remember that.
Being that you weren't part of the team, I'm sure a lot of guys want to get that taste out of their mouth, just last trip, some of the seniors especially, last trip over there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what is that talked about? Is that come up at all with you guys? Or
it hasn't really been talked about. I think that game's probably one of the toughest games to be a part of as a player, especially like for the Georgia players. I mean, it hurt me, and I mean, in no way was a Georgia fan or anything like that, but just to lose like that on like a play like that, it's, you know, that's tough. So I know that all those guys that were there are going to want some, you know, to get that taste out of their mouth. But for me, you know, I'm just, you know, I wasn't there. So I'm just, you know, trying to focus on just doing the best I can.
What kind of weekly question? Have you played at Auburn before? Have you ever been in that stadium at all?
I've been to games.
Okay, but not played there.
I've never played there.
Jay, growing up in Birmingham, I mean, all they do the last 4 or 5 years is talk about how awesome the SEC West is. And mm-hmm. The West has kind of dominated the East this year, 10 out of 11.
Mm-hmm.
Is that a concern going in? Do y'all ever think about that, just how dominant the West has been over the East Division?
No, I don't think about that at all. I think every team in this league has a chance to win every Saturday. And, you know, I definitely don't look at it like that.
What's the mindset and the concern with the quarterback situation at Auburn being it is? Obviously, Jeremy comes back
mm-hmm.
for Sean White this past week. They played better than they have all year on Auburn. Do you have any idea what to expect this week? And
you know, they got two you know, quarterbacks that can get it done. Both do a really good job, do different things well. They got a lot of other guys that they could throw in there, Wildcat, and they can do a lot of different things with the athletes they have on the field. So we just have to do a good job of knowing who's on the field and who can hurt us, and you know how to adjust from there.
Who would you compare them most to at this point? Like in terms of offenses that you played, who would you kind of draw the most comparison to in preparing for them?
You know,
just schematically, not in terms of like talent or anything.
Okay, yeah, schematically, I have to think on that. I mean, they do a lot of motions, a lot of shifts, you know, a lot of different stuff. You know, I remember South Carolina did a lot of motions with Farrell Cooper and stuff like that, but I can't really think of a team. They're pretty unique. You know, Malzahn's kind of, you know, formed his own offense and, you know, really just mastered that. So they're pretty unique in that sense, but they do a lot of different things. They try to confuse you. They line up in different formations but give you the same plays and vice versa. So for us, schematically and, you know, conceptually, we just have to know who can affect us and who's where, and just really have our eyes on the right keys and stuff.